Watch me and Jeannie, we're going viral. Sponsored by Best Western Hotels and Resorts. Check out 70-year-old Greg Popovich getting involved at USA basketball practice.
I love it. Look at him.
Coach, you ever get your hands dirty like this back in the day?
I hope I'm walking at 70 years old. he's hopping. That looks good.
He looks great.
My father-in-law is like that. He's got skills like that.
That's awesome. I love it, man. This is why people love Coach Pop. One of the many reasons people love Coach Pop. You guys got to do these warm-ups. And I love that even when you're on Team USA Basketball, anyone that's played basketball on any level, how do you warm up for a practice? Those stupid little, running across the court, hopping on one leg, all of it, even at that
Not
level,
stupid.
Is still doing it.
Ankle strength. You really want that ankle stability.
Absolutely.
Turn those ankles
and Jenna,
real fast.
He's just not messing around. Pop might have to play. We ain't got many guys. Yeah. Pop might have to get him a couple shots.
He might not be able to field a team at this point.
Hey, Pop was like, let me get this thing ready. Hey, guys, how you doing?
Everyone's dropping out.
We're down to the Plumlee brothers. We might be better off with Coach Pop.
That's funny. All right, Coach Mangini here. On to the Cowboys. Dak Prescott is negotiating a new contract that will reportedly make him one of the 5 highest paid quarterbacks in the NFL.
Yeah, he don't have no show.
That despite the fact that a lot of fans don't view him as an elite quarterback. Hall of Famer and legendary Cowboys wide receiver Michael Irvin completely disagrees. He said, quote, "It's insane sometimes when I hear the analysis on Dak Prescott, and this man has won as many games as he's won. It's like everyone's looking for a reason not to believe instead of opening their eyes for all the reasons they should believe." Coach, what's your reaction to what Michael Irvin had to say?
I don't think the criticism's been unfair. I don't think it's been insane, and I think that it's an element of agreeing to disagree. When you have to talk about a quarterback in the context of he needs this to be successful, he needs this to be successful, he needs his guy at wide receiver, he was a different player when he got... We don't talk about the top quarterbacks that way. When have we talked about the receivers that Tom Brady needs? When have we talked about the elite quarterbacks needing to have this type of running back? It's not part of the equation. The elite guys make other guys better. The elite guys don't have to be supported by this huge cast. Your name's on the marquee if you're a top 5 guy. You're not in a supporting role.
Right, Coach, but what people would argue with you is, though, people like Ben Roethlisberger, yeah, they were no-name guys. He ended up turning them into people. People like to look at them where they had a lot of talent. Aaron Rodgers, well, Jordy Nelson had talent. Or Aaron Rodgers brought it out in him, Donald Driver, Greg Jennings. So I understand you just believe that the quarterback is just more important in the overall development of those other positions than other people do.
Yeah, I just see that receivers that play with elite quarterbacks maximize their ability. And they have opportunities that other guys don't have, where when you're playing with a quarterback that's not elite, the receivers have to be elite, or the running back has to be elite. He's not making other people better. So it's hard to have that discussion when you need so much support in order to be elite.
If you're the quarterback of the Dallas Cowboys, Dak Prescott gets, to Michael Irvin's point, way more criticism than his play deserves and way more props and credit than his play deserves.
Why do you say he gets more criticism
because
than his play deserves?
Because if he were the quarterback for a nondescript team.
Because his team's talking about
him. Right, because we discuss the Cowboys on shows like this every day. They are America's team for a reason. They are the number one ratings draw on Sundays for a reason. So everything is going to be under a microscope. With that comes a lot of benefit. With that also comes extra scrutiny. Dak Prescott's first 3 years in his career, there are some really strong things he's done, his availability, his winning record, and there are some weaker things he's done. But this is his first 3 versus another quarterback's first 3. Another guy who wasn't a first-round pick, by the way. That quarterback is, it's Andy Dalton. Those numbers are almost identical in the first 2 lines. Dalton obviously had more touchdowns, but also way more interceptions. Both took their teams to the playoffs. Dalton did it all 3 years, but didn't win a playoff game. Dak did it 2 of 3, but did win a playoff game. But Dalton was able to kind of fly under the radar. Dalton was, he was what he was. Hey, is a second-round pick pretty good? Dak's 4th-round pick. But we also know and knew then and know now Andy Dalton has a ceiling. And if you are going to be a real contending team with Andy Dalton, you have to have the perfect cast around him, guys playing at a super elite level. That's what how I feel about Dak. You can win a Super Bowl with Dak Prescott as your quarterback, but he just is just going to be a participant in it rather than the leader of it.
The thing that's not fair about your blind reveal is there is you're not showing the personnel that Andy Dalton played with. Andy Dalton had a very good offensive line, and they had a very creative offense. They had Julio Jones. A.J. Green was second best to Julio Jones. And I'm talking about an elite wide receiver.
Sure.
They had another 1,000-yard receiver. They had tight ends. They had two or three running backs during that period that were successful.
But the running backs weren't Zeke. They had been Jarvis Green, Ellis, and Cedric Benson.
Let me present my case.
Okay,
you
sure.
had your information.
Sure.
You did what you wanted to do with it. Now let me talk about it. The Cincinnati Bengals were underrated, and what Andy Dalton was working with was great talent. That's the reason why you say, oh, I could see his ceiling. That he hadn't worked with elite talent. So you don't know what his ceiling is. And I've just seen, go ahead.
I feel like Dak's had an elite offensive line, an elite running back his whole career. He has not had elite wide receivers. But he's had, I think that the Cowboys supporting cast around Dak has been well above league average. He's had the best running back in football his whole career.
Yeah, I can understand that, Nick. But we're talking about developing as a passer.
Sure.
If you have a great running back, it does not help you develop as a passer. How you develop as a passer? Well, get out there and throw some passes. And who are you going to throw it to? I don't have a tight end. Everyone at the Z receiver is inexperienced. I spent a half a season with Amari Cooper. Oh, my passing rating went up 14 points. So let's just see where this ends at. If Andy Dalton was continued to trend up, because that graphic didn't tell that. That is trending up. Amari just got there. Michael Gallup on the other side gives them a speed option. Randall Cobb in the slot with a running back. Not the best running back in football. Their offense would be so much more effective. Maybe some movement pre-snap. Move guys around instead of trying to overpower guys. Maybe that would help him out, which this new offense is going to try to do. The thing about Andy Dalton is, yes, you could tell. He had a good offensive line, had good running backs, had great wide receivers. Yeah, you can top him off right there. Dak, it wouldn't be fair or it wouldn't be smart. I didn't know who Drew Brees was after 3 years. I didn't know he was going to be one of the top five passers in almost every single category. I didn't know that. Randall Cunningham, I didn't know he was going to be an MVP, get knocked out of football, didn't come back and be another MVP, learn how to throw the ball in his mid-30s. I'm talking about throwing it all over the field. So I have seen guys develop, and I saw my own development in this league with putting the right things around me to be ginormous late in your 20s. So I'm not putting Dak in some box as if, oh, this personnel has really illuminated his ability. No, it hadn't, because you need wide receivers to develop a passer. That's why Drew Brees, when he left the San Diego Chargers and came to with Sean Payton and all those receivers and everything, we didn't know that about Drew Brees, because if he was, Nick Saban would still be in Miami. He wouldn't have went with Dante Culpepper and would have said, you know something? Drew Brees is going to hit a few more tiers in his life.
It's what we say about quarterbacks. You're a tractor or you're a trailer. And if you are pulling everyone else around you, or are you getting pulled by everyone else around you? Can you change positions 3, 4, 5 years into the league? Can Dak Prescott do that?
I do, and Chris makes a really good point. He has excellent traits. He has excellent intangibles. He studies. He works hard. He's got great relationships with the players that he's with. And that's going to continue to help him grow. And he does something really important. Most games in the NFL are lost, not won. He doesn't lose a lot of games. So that's a huge starting point for the Cowboys. And when I think back to Tom Brady, he was a guy that obviously didn't come under a lot of scrutiny early because of where he was drafted and how he came out. And he had the luxury of being able to develop mm-hmm. without all the same pressure that Dak has. But he had to develop. He was not good the first year as a New England Patriot. And even the year that we won the Super Bowl, we threw 3 offensive touchdowns in the playoffs. But he continued to get better. So in fairness to Dak, that his traits and his intangibles and his decision-making give him a chance to continue to improve.
The issue for him, though, is it might just be he's in a very difficult era, and that you're right, and I'm not trying to put a ceiling on him. What I am saying is it is hard for me to envision him ever taking the type of progression Drew Brees did, which is a very unique in NFL history progression. Yeah. It is hard for me to envision him, when we have the best passers we've ever had in this league, ever finding himself anywhere near the top of that list. And so those other traits are going to have to be all-time great, the way Tom Brady's are, and he developed as a passer.
Well, this is the thing, Nick. I just believe you need to open up your mind. I think you shouldn't put quarterbacks in that type of corner of what they're going to be and what not they're going to be. Because I've seen systems, I've seen players come in, and players just blossom. It's just not fair to them. And the other thing that I'll give Dak, all right? And Mike Irvin and I talk about this a lot. Me and Mike been friends since high school. We were high school All-Americans together. We were college All-Americans. We are the same age. Our career in the NFL spanned the same amount of time. I don't know if I would have been successful playing for the Cowboys. It's a lot of pressure. It's a lot of issues there in Dallas. They love their Cowboys, and the exposure the players get, I don't know if that would have been best for me. Being off in Minnesota, off Broadway a little bit, it really helped me develop. What Dak has done, being the quarterback with Jerry Jones and his son doing every press conference with all the glitz, all the glamour, Dak has done amazing. And I don't think people are giving him enough credit for that. If Andy Dalton had gone back to Texas and played for the Cowboys, it would have crushed him. He'd be a backup somewhere. He wouldn't still be no starting quarterback. So we need to give people credit. When they get on Broadway, how they handle that. And Dak has handled it. I'm sure Coach is very, very comfortable saying that. That spotlight in Dallas, my man Bill Parcells, he coached there. He told me it's hot there after even coaching in New York. What Dak has done with that has been stellar.
Yeah, it has been impressive. And the thing that gets lost is when we talk about him getting paid like a top five guy and you think of him in that context, it's hard to think of him like that now, but it doesn't mean he can't become that at some point.
All right, take a break.
Great to see you,
Coach.
See you
thank too. You.
Thank you.
Okay. Can Kevin Durant be the same player after returning from his Achilles injury? Talk KD next on First Things First.
Punch holes in.
We're going to go through week by week.